In the mid-1970s, a genre of horror films was invented called the slasher flick. In these films, you have a series of murders, just one after another after another. Now, Siskel and Ebert, the film critics, have once said that they can tell every time which side of the screen the boogeyman is going to appear, because they've seen so many of these, and they recognize that there's a definite formula at work. And if you know the formula, then the movie is not only not scary, but it's extremely predictable. Now, we're going to present that formula to you here, in which case I'm going to be the victim.
How did this get open?
It's supposed to be locked. Hello? Is anybody in here? Jeff? Is that you? Hello? Is anybody down here? Jeff? As you can plainly see, the modern concept of the scary movie has a definite formula behind it, and the formula is to make you as scared as possible using tricks that they've learned by making movies before.
But God has a different formula, one that's not based on fear like the movies are, but one of power and love and a sound mind. The movies try to sell you the fear of death and just fear.
But how is that different from the world, to be honest? Is there a formula at work to keep us scared? And isn't fear the sort of thing that the devil wants us Christians to go through?
God is telling you that you don't have to be afraid of death or be afraid of anything. He conquered death.
Now, according to this formula that the world has, we are supposed to be terrified of everything. And yet we have a very strong ally. God the Father has sent His Son here to die on the cross for our sins so that we could have fellowship with Him.
In 2 Timothy 1:7 it says, "For God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind."
If God can be for us, then who can be against us? What is it that we have in this world that we're supposed to be scared of? What is more powerful than God? Okay, here's the real beauty of it. This is beautiful. We're supposed to be scared of death, but we have a living Savior who has conquered death already.
Anything that comes along in our lives that might make us afraid or make us have anxiety over dying, God has died on the cross and rose from the dead to conquer death. So we don't have to fear death. We don't have to fear anything. As long as God is in your heart, everything's going to be taken care of according to His plan.
We cling to Him. There's nothing that we can be scared of. Even death.
So we hope you enjoyed tonight. And if you didn't enjoy it, I'm sorry. We're trying. So maybe next time. But anyway, we hope you enjoyed it. And thank you.